Hey guys, this is Martin again from Church Electronics, and today I wanted to talk about the differences between 5-pin DMX and 3-pin DMX. A lot of you may have questions, what is the difference and why there's such a variation from interfaces to fixtures and different products that involve DMX. The main reason why DMX was originally invented being a 5-pin was to differentiate signals from audio and lighting signals. The reason being is because if you're to plug in a DMX fixture with an audio signal or vice versa, you could actually damage the equipment. DMX 5-pin has 5 pins, obviously, and pins 4 and 5, they are usually used for secondary data or other things like that that different companies may find the use for. But nowadays, most companies just use pins 1, 2, and 3. Pin 1 is usually the ground, 2 is a data negative, and pin 3 is a positive. So that's the main reason why the DMX pinouts vary. But I mean, it's the same base pinout, 1, 2, 3, and 5. Like I said, 4 and 5 have been used for different things throughout the time, but nowadays everything's just running on 3-pin. So basically here we got a couple different interfaces that show you examples of 3 and 5-pin variations. For example, like the Entek DMX USB Pro, that one comes in 5-pin and it has an input and an output running in 5-pin. Then we got the C2 First Class. This one actually has a 5 and it's got a 3-pin as well, all together in one. So that one kind of gives you options. You know, obviously one of them it's the first universe and the other one's the second universe. And then also we got the LD Nano right here, the Lumidesk Nano. That one only comes with 3-pin. So, you know, like I said, there's a lot of variations, but nowadays most things run in 3-pin, but the standard, the industry standard, is still 5-pin. There's also a 3 to 5-pin adapters like this one right here. And, you know, they sell them, we actually sell these in both ways, either 5-pin male or 5-pin female, depending on what kind of a conversion you need. So, you know, like I said, you could easily convert from 3 to 5 or 5 to 3, whatever it is that you may need. So, you know, if you get a fixture or if you get an interface and it's a 5-pin and you're running 3-pin, you know, it's not the end of the world. You could always convert it quite easily and without any effects or repercussions from it. So that's pretty much all that I wanted to show you guys and talk about. So I really hope this video was helpful. If you guys have any questions, any comments, concerns, anything like that, don't forget to drop us a comment. Don't forget to subscribe and also check out our website at seriousasc.com. Thanks for watching.